Good morning. This is Erica. Welcome back to part two of my series on why does God want us to honor? So in part one, I discussed the meaning of honor, and the meaning of honor is to respect, to be obedient, to make someone's request more important than yours, to take the weight off their shoulders, and it's also how you talk about them when they are not present. That's honoring them. So let's get right into it. So why does God want us to honor, especially when some people are not the easiest people to honor? Like, you probably have a boss or a manager, maybe your mom or your dad, your uncle, auntie. They could be harsh, and God still wants you to honor them. But why? First off, to represent Jesus. So in 1 John 2:6, it says, whoever claims to live in him must live as Jesus did. If you're claiming to be a believer in Jesus in your heart, you have to walk as Jesus did. So that is a number one reason why God wants us to honor those. Number two is you hinder your prayer requests. In 1 Peter 3:7, it says, husbands that are not honoring their wife, their prayers are hindered. And we all know that we do not want that to happen. We want our prayers to go up there to God. And then another reason is to be blessed. So in Ephesians 6:8, it says, because you know that the Lord will reward each one for whatever good they do, whether they are a slave or free. So honoring those is how you get blessed as well. So also, to help others be saved. So you have to think how you walk helps other people get to salvation, because we are the church. So the good that people see you do is the reason why they will thank God and even inquire about salvation. So also, so they can thank God for us. In 1 Peter 2:12, it says, live such good lives among the pagans that though they accuse you of doing wrong, they may see your good deeds and glorify God on the day that he visits us. So to stack your treasures in heaven. So in Matthew 6:19-20, it says, do not store up your treasures on the earth where moths and vermin destroy and where thieves break in and steal, but store up for yourself treasures in heaven where moths and vermin do not destroy and where thieves do not break in and steal. Honoring is storing your treasures, okay? So also to show grace to others as well. In Leviticus 19:18, it says, do not seek revenge or bear a grudge against anyone among people, but love your neighbor as yourself. So you have to be willing to give others grace in this walk. Not only that, giving other grace is also saying that I know the person that you are today is not going to be the person that you're going to be. I know that the way that God changed me, God can change you as well, because he did it for me and I know he can do it for you. And this is why we give others grace, because of the faith that's in us. We know that God is the God that can make the impossible possible. So therefore, honor those and give them grace while you do it. To show love. In Romans 12:2, it says, be devoted to one another in love, honor one another above yourself. So showing love to someone is honoring them and is putting them above you. So you will be stronger in spirit. 2 Corinthians 12:2, it says, that is why for Christ's sake, I delight in weaknesses and insults and hardships and persecutions and difficulties. For when I am weak, then I am strong. So when you're honoring someone that is harsh or just difficult, you are weakened. And God knows this, but he will step in and make you even stronger. That's why we honor them. So you can be an example of biblical characters. We see so many people in the Bible live out such an honorable character. You see David, King David, being chased by Saul for many years for something that he did not do wrong. And you see David still honor him. David even actually apologized to him and made another covenant with him and vowed to Saul that he would never kill him. So, and David respected Saul a lot, not because for any other reason other than Saul being God's appointed king. So he knew that this is someone that God appointed to be king, so I am going to honor him despite the fact that he is trying to kill me. So you see, you even see it in Daniel. Every time Daniel addressed the kings, you see the respect and the honor and how he spoke to them. And you would think this was a young man that was stolen from his country and his genitals ripped off. He will probably in his mind have every right to have attitude, to be upset. But every time he spoke to them, he always spoke in honor. So you have to represent Jesus well. Honoring others also honors God. Hello. If we really want to honor God, we have to honor others. This is a command. This is a promise. So anyway, I hope this inspires you, and I hope you come back for my part 3, where I am going to discuss how do we do this? How do we honor these people when they are hard? They are difficult to deal with. All of these things are hard to do. I know it is, but guess what? We have the Lord Jesus, our Savior, to help you. He has left the Holy Spirit in you to be able to live out being able to honor those, especially those who are difficult. So I hope you come back to part 3 so you can see the how.